This is Running, a complete beginner's guide to running for all distance runners, from milers to ultramarathoners. Proven tactics to improve running performance and prevent injury. Written by George M. Silverstein. Read by Nick Dolle. Introduction. You can stay in shape by running. It does not matter what kind you are doing. You can effectively get rid of some calories by doing it. When you are distance running, it can be a great way to train for a marathon or some other kind of race. However, that does not mean that running distance is for marathons only. There are people who use distance running to lose excess weight or just to stay fit. Each person can adapt to different speeds and distances for their own personal agenda. Since everybody's body is different, everyone will not run at the same pace. If you are a beginner with distance running, then you will want to take your time. Don't rush it, especially because it's a new process for you. You have to give yourself time to shape up or whatever your plans were. Rome was not built in a day, so you will also have to take it day by day. Before you know it, you will be appreciative that you did not rush to any decisions concerning distance running and training. This audiobook will discuss 6 different types of distance running: sprinting, middle distance running, marathon running, long distance running, ultra running, multi-day running. You can also have mental benefits from doing this kind of training program with distance running. So whatever you set out to do, make sure that it's worthwhile for yourself, your body, and other people. No decision that you make affects just you. It affects other people as well. So as you start on your training journey, keep in mind that this is not a popularity contest on who can run the fastest or the longest. It's about training your body through different kinds of distance running techniques. Sprinting. When athletes are sprinting, they are running as fast as they can within a short distance. With sprinting, they don't have to pace themselves. The 100-meter dash is the most well-known distance that is affiliated with sprinting. A runner is required to be at a starting block in order to start. They are allowed to push themselves off. When they are in a stance, they are bending over using one or both of their hands. Their hands are on the ground and move from that setting when they start running. As the runners take off, they are running beside each other, going towards the finish line. With sprinting, there are distances of 100, 200, and 400 meters. The latter, used in Olympic Games. If sprinting is done on an indoor track, then it is usually a 60-meter sprint. With the 60 and 100-meter sprints, the runners use the track straight away. The 200 and 400 use the bends in the oval. A runner has a 4-foot-wide lane in which to run. Sprinters need to maintain core muscles, balance, and posture while they are training and beyond. The purpose is for them to use less energy and be able to run at a speed that is faster than what they normally run. If they jog for an hour, it is not as effective as running in short, fast bursts. The jogs do not provide sprinters any justice. As sprinters train, they use less time getting fit than they would if they incorporated regular exercises. In order for the training to be effective, sprinters must have proper running shoes, a stopwatch, and a person that can time them for accuracy. As with any training, you must do stretches to avoid being injured. The recommended time is no less than 10 seconds and no more than 30 seconds of stretching. You would stretch your legs and your torso area. After that, you would warm up with a 1-minute.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.